Hey Career Gears, Robert here and welcome back to a new video. In this video we will give you a step-by-step tutorial of how we make our animated Splatoon text boxes. Because in the WVD Discord server, I was asked how Muna and I made these new text boxes. So I thought it would be fun to show you guys how we make these and in the process make a new set for a later project. So that's going to be enough blathering, let's get started! First thing I made for the text boxes was the icon. For this I started with Sheldon because most of my projects are weapon props, so I thought it would be fitting to put Sheldon in them. For this design I used a low quality icon from Hero Mode, since those were the only ones to be found. And I traced this in Adobe Illustrator. Here I mostly used the pen tool to create the pass, and with the use of the gradient fill and handy layering I was able to replicate Sheldon. When I was finished with the design, I used a copy of the background and I grouped the shapes as one object in Illustrator to use as a clipping mask. This will cut off all the excess parts of the object. And with this, I finished up the Sheldon icon. Next was the text box itself. This I did in two parts. For the first part, I started with two rectangles and rounded up the outside corners. Some more than others. Then I started to work on the white parts of the drawing with first a white square to locate where the icon is going to be placed, and after that I started to work with some smaller rectangles to make the dotted line at the top of the text box. With these I just copy and paste them and use the central line and equal divide tool to take care of the placements. Just checking the placement with the new icon and adjusting its size for a text box with a 920 by 1080p workspace. For the second part, I started to work on the texture of the text box. For this I created a workspace of 12,170 pixels by 885 to get the height and 3 times the length of the text box base to create our looping texture on. Next I got a dark grey background and used some black stripes under a 30 degree angle for the details. If it seems too dark, don't worry, because later on we're going to lower the opacity of the texture for an added effect. But this texture needs to be able to loop, so in the end we're going to make them the same. And again, we used a copy of the background for a clapping mask. And finally, we're going to save this as four individual parts. The texture, the base of the text box for placement reference, the white parts of the text box, and a third of the length of the texture so we can work it as a base for the next part, making the texture animated. For this, I'm using Adobe Premiere Pro. In this, we are editing the third of the texture and the looping texture. First, we add the third to make a base and set the sizing of the media. Next, we add the looping texture. After this, we are editing the texture. First, we make it last 20 seconds. Second, we drag it to its position all the way to the right. Third, we set this as a marker. Fourth, we drag it all the way to its corresponding place on the left. And we add this as a marker at the end of the 20 seconds. You can render this out, but it's the base for the animated texture. After this, we're going to export this. This can be done just as an MP4 file. I would suggest rendering it at 60 frames per second to get a smooth animation. First we add text box, but we add this in layer 2 because I personally always like to add a transparency background when I make these just to make it a bit easier to spot the opacity change. Next we add the icon. Here you can play with the size and the placement because this will probably differ from project to project, but I would at least add scale to frame size. When it's in place, we add the name of the character. For this, we draw out the text box on the top where the name usually is placed and type out the name, Sheldon in this case. Next, I add the font Project Paintball. This is a Splatoon-based type font that you can download from the internet. Note, we did not own this font, we just used it in our video graphics around Splatoon. After the font is added, we scale and add the color, in this case green. And I also always like to add a drop shadow. This gives the text just a bit more of a Splatoon style. We achieved this by putting on some black for the color, putting the opacity to 100, shadow distance to 16, shadow size to 8, and the feather to 0. You can fiddle around with the placement of the text box a bit, but it's just a taste because this can also differ per name. Next, we finally add the texture. For this, we add in the video of the looping texture and search up the effect Track Matte Key and place this in the video. Next, we open Photoshop via New to Photoshop file and drag in the base texture. After this, we select the outside and reverse the selection. Then we fill up the base with any color we want and save this document. When we close the window, we have to file in our assembly. So the only logical thing to do is add it in. After this is added, we go to the effects menu of the texture movie. We look up the option for the track matte key. Here you can select which layer of the track matte key will be used for the cutting. In this case, we take track 3. This will cut out the video to the contour of the image in track 3. But as you can see, sometimes it does need a little bit more scaling to fit perfectly. After this scaling, I always like to add a transparency to the background to give it a little more effect to the text box. I mostly use it around 85% opacity. And with some cutting and sizing and rendering, we have our very own text boxes. Maybe the text box is going a bit too quickly for your liking way you've made this, but you can always edit the speed / duration of the texture video. But in this case, we're only going to be able to see them on screen for a max of 5 seconds, so I like the way they move. Next, I use the in and out field of the function to select a 5 second clip and export this. Don't forget to hide the transparency background, by the way. This is also an important step if you want to have the video with a transparent background. For this, we are going to use the format QuickTime. The present doesn't matter, but below we are going to need to put the video codec on animation. For the scale, you can click on the box on the right to make it jump to the size of the project, and then you can use the link to the locked ratio, and then you can edit these to your preferred size, probably somewhere around 1080. You can also choose the frame rate. I chose 60 frames per second because I want a smooth asset. But 30 frames a second can also just easily be used. With the final important parts, we select within depth 8 BPC plus alpha. Because with this, it will render out text box with a transparent background. This option is only available under animation. And if you want to have the full 20 seconds of the text boxes, you can select entire sequence, but because I use the in-out tool, I use sequence in-out for the 5 seconds of animation. And when these are all to your liking, you can export the text box. And the beauty of the system is that you only have to change the icon, for example to Marie. And change the text and the color in the name to have a completely different text box. This can even be done for Kelly. After this, the next step is to add the text box to your project. For this, we add the text boxes to our library on Premiere Pro and drag the text boxes onto our timeline. Then scale it to frame size. Also, I always like to give it a size of 90 after this. Then you can place the text box at the bottom of the shot. Next, we use the text tool to add the words that the characters say. For this, I also use Project Paintball and give it a 150 size and center the lines. Next, I add a drop shadow, just like on the names of the text box. And I use the cursor tool to edit the size and placing a little bit. And I crop the scene to make the text last as long as the text box. Next are the animations. For this, I use the scale function to play around a bit, with a 0 scale at the beginning and the end, and 6 frames before that the final scale. But I like to give it a bit more action, so I like to add on frame 4 a scale that's a bit larger than the size we started with to give it a little bit more of a bounce. And for the text, I use the effect Linear Wipe and drag this onto the text. With this, I like to end the wipe around 1/3 or 1/4 of the time of the text box. And I give it a 270 degree angle to make it slide from the left to the right. And don't forget to give it the outro animation as well. And then we render it to see what we've made. Nice! Just a few more minor touches. Drag the anchor to make sure the text disappears at that spot. But with the same ease as making the text boxes, we can add another text box. This can be done by copying the text fragment and the animation keys from the first text box. And to finish it off, we can add some voice clips from the game. I will leave a link to the site I used for my Splatoon and Splatoon 2 voice clips. Just trimming those and placing them almost where the wipe stops, and we have some finished text boxes, and here are the end results. Hey Career Gears, we hope you enjoyed the video. This was a video we wanted to do on the site because one of the Career Gears in the Discord server asked us if we could make a tutorial video about how we make our new animated text boxes. So Muna was able to convince me to do it, and we hope you enjoyed it and are able to give it a go yourself. But if there's any project or other thing you would like to see us show you, you can leave it down in the comments or join a Discord server for an even quicker and more personal answer. But that's going to be all from us now. Keep those creative gears turning. See you in the next video.